Welcome to the MSIS podcast series. This is your host Rini Dantas, and today we are talking to the CTO of MSIS Technologies, Mr. Nitish Sirsa. Hello, Nitish.
Hey, hi, Rini.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you, Rini?
I'm good, thank you. So, Nitish, you know, we want to learn a little more about MSIS Technologies. So, but before we start about MSIS Technologies, we'd like to know a little about you.
Well, Rini, as the Chief Technology Officer, I head the entire technology team here at MSIS Technologies. Personally, my area of expertise has been into the areas of operating systems, kernel, enterprise applications, some of the system management, cloud, virtualization, especially around the data center area and some of the cloud management areas.
Okay.
I've also been actively connected with some of the academic research. I'm connected with a couple of universities where I talk to some of the research scholars in the field of operating systems mm-hmm. and virtualization, mm-hmm. Guide them with any of the information that they need.
Okay.
And additionally, I have also along with a few of my friends, I also founded an NGO that works into a public education area
okay.
where we educate people onto some of the citizen-centric government acts and laws
okay.
and those acts could be like Right to Information Act, Right to Services Act, Jal Lokpal
mm-hmm.
and all of those citizen-centric acts basically.
Okay. So could you tell us about your experience before coming to MSIS?
Certainly. So before coming to MSIS, I gathered almost more than 20 years of experience in
mm-hmm.
the field of computer software. Just a slight deviation there, I mean, I also founded a couple of ventures in the areas of childhood education and also in the sector of automotives. Coming back to computer software, I mean, prior to joining MSIS, I was with BMC Software, which worked and where I was actually managing the teams that built the software for managing heterogeneous clouds
okay.
in the data centers. And that meant managing all of the day one and day two operations, taking care of the entire data center regardless of the hypervisors and the virtualization platforms that they use.
Mm-hmm.
It was mainly around some application performance, scalability related things, the monitoring of your different services and the data center operations. Prior to that, I was with VMware and Hewlett Packard, where I spent quite a few years, where I was managing the teams which built the softwares around some of the system management products, ESX server kernel, the CPU scheduler memory management part
mm-hmm.
of it. Also some of the network and storage stack products for both these companies.
Oh, that's a lot of experience. So you've been in MSIS for some time now. So how would you describe MSIS Technologies?
So Rini, MSIS is primarily a product development and engineering company.
Mm-hmm.
We provide some high technology services in storage, cloud computing, DevOps, big data analytics, embedded systems, Internet of Things, test automation. We provide these services to some technology startups, some of the mid-size or large enterprises. Our head office is located in Chennai,
okay.
in India. And we also have an office in US that's located in Alpharetta,
mm-hmm.
Georgia. And we also have the presence, our engineering presence in the Indian cities of Bangalore and Pune. And Bangalore and Pune happen to be the major technology hubs, information technology hubs in India.
Yeah, of course. We'd also like to know about the MSIS story, if you don't mind.
Well, MSIS as a company was founded in 2007. It was founded by our CEO, Sanjay Sahagal. He started with a commitment to deliver the best IT services and automation software to the enterprises. We quickly built reputation as the preferred innovation partner in storage, cloud computing, embedded system, testing and test automation areas. We have helped so far more than 100 customers in building their products and modernizing their products.
Oh, that's impressive. So, do you have a strong leadership team that helps you accomplish all this?
Of course, we do have. So, in fact, we are really proud to have some of the key leaders in the IT industry in our management team.
Mm-hmm.
We, of course, have Sanjay Sahagal, who's our CEO.
Uh-huh.
He guides us like on a daily basis. We also have Pichai Mani Muthuviran, who's the vice president of our engineering team, handling most of the delivery operations. Geeta is our Vice President of Training and she also handles the US recruitment part of the
okay.
company. We have Joshua Clemens as the vice president of our IT, HR and operations team. Rahul Kashru heads our business development team here at MCS. We have Shanmuga Sundaram as the director of finance and accounts team.
Okay.
Yeah, and so we also have Ahmed Hussain as an advisor onto our board.
Okay.
He is a veteran technologist working in the field of information technology for past 25 years.
No, okay. So this is the leadership team. What about the team at large, you know, the workforce of the company? What is your approach to career development or, you know, building the team, so to say?
Well, yeah, we create team visions and values which defines the purpose of our teams. We identify some common challenges that we all can get behind as a team.
Mm-hmm.
We also work on something more like a best fit team structure to support our vision.
Mm-hmm.
And we make sure that we clarify work roles and responsibilities, which helps understanding contributions each one of us makes to the company. There is a clarity on the levels of authority and responsibility, and that helps us understanding or rather having a clear decision making process.
So that's a very transparent.
Yeah, that's true. And we also have some processes for handling the problems where we kind of figure out the ways to do better or have some clarity around the decision making and the business decisions process.
Okay. So, Nitish, if you were to tell us what is your focus area and what are the market for MCS, what would you think that would be?
Looking at our mission, following through our mission, we focus our efforts mainly through the involvement in the domains like storage, cloud technologies, Internet of Things, DevOps, Big Data Analytics and Test Automation.
Mm-hmm.
Now these happen to be, I mean, rather we retain that as our major focus areas from the technology perspective.
Okay. And what are the services that make a part of the MCS service portfolio?
So we offer technical services like product lifecycle management, cloud computing, enterprise application, some of the big data and analytics services.
Mm-hmm.
We also offer some quality assurance, storage development, and also product sustenance as our services. We actually have combined our expertise with our deep domain understanding that we have built over these years. And we use that to launch our own solution accelerators, which are rather our own IPs,
okay.
Something like Movitas, MTAS, and Purple Strike RT, and these happen to be the front runners in their own domains now.
Oh, okay. Can you tell us something about your customers?
So most of our customers are from the software vertical, from the software enterprises. From the time of its launch till today, we have worked with more than 100 customers. Some of the major customers, the major engagements that we have are with Share, Citrix, Gravitant, Coho Data,
mm-hmm.
or Nimble Data, just a sample of that. So far, we have received lots of positive feedback from our customers, and that's something that keeps us motivated to do better and deliver better.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, as an industry, you know, at your target industry, where do you think that is headed in the coming future?
So, if you look at the current market trend, Srini, there is a wealth, lots of chatter and hype around the storage and cloud happening right now.
Mm-hmm.
You have the software-defined storage, even the conventional and traditional storage, and some of the cloud computing areas. As more startups continue to go public, this chatter kind of intensifies.
Mm-hmm.
Separating the hype and fleeting these trends from reality is rather difficult.
Okay.
But then as we see more and more companies adopt cloud, these technologies are accelerating in a global fashion. More development is going to go to cloud. Increased competition in the cloud space will give ways for better products, services and innovation into these areas.
Mm-hmm. Would you like to also add a comment on the strategic partnerships?
Certainly. So MCS core competency is delivering best in class cloud systems integration and applications development. Our partnership and experience with some companies like Amazon Web Services, Share, Citrix Systems, Apache Cloud Stack and Tata Communications, Instacompute, This enables us to kind of offer high performing solutions tailored with the tools and capabilities that fit into the day-to-day processes and long-term needs of our customers. We have like multiple of these partnerships with many of the industry leaders who have been pioneers into their field.
So with your customers and with your strategic partnerships, where do you think is MSIS headed? What are your future plans for?
We certainly strive to strengthen the domestic core business that we have by building in and discovering some new talent and expanding our technical portfolio. While it's natural for the company to work on improving earnings by aggressively promoting the activities of the existing domains, it's also particularly important for us to increase the number of experts into some of the newer technology or emerging technology areas. We are a growing company. We'll continue focusing on discovering and training new talent into the future, keeping an eye on expanding our technology portfolio.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying that you're in sync, in perfect sync with the MSIS vision?
Of course, Rini. So innovation is our lifeblood,
driving
us constantly in providing some inspiring solutions to our customers into the focus areas. Our innovative solutions continue to provide monumental business growth to some of our existing customers.
So that's a lot of information about MSIS that we've come to know about today. Thanks, Nitish. But on a parting note, do you want to say something about brand MSIS?
So MSIS Technologies has come a long way from its early days. With aspects like continued innovations and delivering values to clients, we believe in doing things differently. We have striven to bring class to our engagement areas, every single engagement that we have. We have proven time and again how we can be exceptional in our work. We take pride in thinking innovatively and uniquely. MSIS Technologies is a global tech company. We work as a single entity to provide mission critical solutions. We encourage our technologists to take ownership of the problems of our customers. And we respect our people and provide a wonderful work environment. The result, they value us greatly and stay with us. Our experience working with leading tech companies for nearly a decade has helped us provide end-to-end solutions in all of our domains.
Wow, so we've learned a lot about MSIS Technologies today. It's wonderful having you on this show. Thank you so much for your time, Nitish.
Thank you so much, Rini.
Hope to see you again.
Sure.
That brings us to the end of our podcast. Thanks for listening. If you have any feedback for us, you can write to us at marketing@msistechnologies.com. If you would like to hear about anything else in the future, please let us know. We'll be right back. Until next time, take care.